Alright, what's up guys, and welcome back to Maximum Replacement Policy Reasons Splatoon, episode 224. Let's hop right in. We're playing Tower Control in Moray Towers and Ontovi Games. We are using, what is the name of this weapon again? The Neo Splooshomatic. I was correct in the last episode when I said I was going to be using this weapon. Let's do it. I was using this on, what map was it? Mahi Mahi, yeah, it's Mahi Mahi Resort, Splat Zones, and I was using Neo Splooshomatic, and the point sensor is honestly one of the best subs I've ever used. It is so helpful, especially for a weapon that doesn't have great range. The ability to throw something, or the ability to know where your opponent is, so you don't have to like pre-fire, sort of hoping that you pick them out, is so helpful. All right, so I'm immediately pushing down mid. Dang it. That Kraken. I'm surprised I didn't get any hits on that roller. Honestly, where I had a lot of success when we were playing with Rainmaker? No, it was probably Splat Zones. And also, it doesn't lose nearly as much ink. Like as most SMGs. Oh, that was so unlucky. All right, he's pushing low. 51's not bad though, so we'll take 51. I'm sort of expecting. Are you Joe? I don't know why I was protected. I guess I saw the tower on the or the like that yellow spire thing on the tower. I was like, oh, it's a wall. Duh. But no, it's not. Are you? And I didn't even get that kill. Oh my god. Oh, that's what frustrates me more though, because I understand that I maybe could have not gotten that kill. Or I probably did end up deserve to get killed, I mean. But I actually did get that kill. I'm positive of that. Right. I actually think this is probably one of the better spots I can play. I also have my Kraken, so if I need to go start hopping on towers, that's an option. Do we just have one fall off the map? Interesting. Again, despite the fact that it's an SMG, I actually find it really good as a defensive weapon. I don't know how he saw me. That's what I'm wondering. Like, for them to kill me on that last kill, I don't know how they saw me. They must have seen me swim up. That's about the only way that would have happened. Which is unfortunate. But we did win. So we will take that as the positive. What did we go? We started out slow, but once I sort of got into a rhythm, it was better. 5-5. That's about what I would give. 1-9 for the roller. But the rest of the team did pretty well. Yeah. What time is it? When are these stages? So 6. They rotate at 10, so I'll have an hour after I finish recording, because it'll be closer. It'll be close-ish to 9. It'll be probably 9:10, 9:15, maybe. I don't know. We'll see. Depending on, like, when the episode ends. So... Alright, I really want to play Anchovy Games because I want to flank, I think, and I want to sit behind that box. That's literally my goal, is to flank and then sit behind the box. Roller? I hate roller. If I could ban one weapon every single time, it would be rollers. Not snipers, not Luna Blaster, it would be rollers. Because most of the kills that just, like... Oh, I can't die there. I should have waited. I should have been more patient. I just got so anxious. I was like, oh, kill, kill, kill. Because it worked, though. Like, I had such a huge advantage on that player. And spot bomb? Yep, spot bomb got me. Odd angle, looking through the box, not going to lie. Okay, now it's a 1v2. Not good. Gonna play right here. Now we push it. And I get killed. Those are literally, I hate when that happens. Because they are the dumbest kills, because they don't deserve to end. Why am I lagging? It looks to be a little bit better now, but come on. The fact that I can't even hit that is sort of disappointing. Wait, what? All right, well. I still don't know how the heck they got it that far. We do throw a lot of those. Are you what? Oh, there's a Luna Blaster behind me. I was going to say, I never saw that guy shoot. We had this tune. We just let them make a stupid play on us. I was so screwed. Oh, I thought I had him. That's one of the tough things about playing against the Splooshomatic, is that they move very quickly. Oh, Jesus. I actually have my Kraken as well. Oh my god, of course. The worst. If I'd known that it was a Kraken, I would have popped mine. It would not have been an issue. And we would have given ourselves at least a better chance of winning. I feel like it's not about who can get the most kills. It's just about who can hit the most point sensors. The point sensors are a lot of fun to throw, though. I'm not gonna lie. Okay. This will probably be game. Maybe not, actually. We might be able to get one. I just couldn't turn on that guy quick enough. Ugh. Oh well. We tried. That was a little bit of a more frustrating game for me. Simply because... Oops, sorry. There. 14 and 10. We actually played really well. And I think I don't know. I definitely could have done better. I don't know. I think the 52 gal actually might be a really good weapon for this map, because that splash wall can be so just game changing. I don't know. I find there are certain maps where I know that the Splooshmatic could be great. Something like I'm so bad. I never remember this one. It's the shipping yard. It has the lanes. What is it? Not Bluefin Depot. Port Mackerel. Port Mackerel, I think this could be really good, because you get into so many close engagements, especially if you're pushing into one of the lanes that runs horizontally and not vertically, because vertically is way more focused on the Splooshmatic as well. Okay, see, we should be picking this up because they had literally one player left. That's a nice trade. I sort of expected that. I figured that was the Splooshmatic because I saw it shooting earlier. And I thought I could probably trade that. Or that's what I was expecting, it was to trade it. Oh, and we... Oh, this weapon kills so quickly. It's awesome. Oh, no. I'm so used to the Rainmaker map where you actually do have that space. Would obviously not have made that play. Had I, and thing is, I was like, wait, is that even here on this map? Because I was so confused. I knew there was, I was hoping I would beat the guy up, get the one behind me, and then kill that guy. That was just unlucky. I should have turned on the guy first. I should have, figured that, I should have trusted my teammate to get that kill. What the heck? Oh. Surprised they saw me there. Right, they have way too many beacons up, and it's killing us. Again, if you don't break beacons, your team is in so much trouble. Oh, we need that snipe. That would have been huge. Oh, and then I got one burst by the Lusa. No, regular splash shot. Oh, that's frustrating. Also, can we not let them have beacons all over the place? I understand that it is, like, easier said than done, but... Two shots. Oh! I don't know how we can't even break this right now. That's the most embarrassing part. I did turn on that guy. Oh, the Luna Blaster killed me. I was like, that guy literally just respawns instantly. It's ridiculous. Why do we need to? Okay. Alright, so they are one less beacon because they did have one there. Are you joking me? How did I die there? I don't understand. He doesn't even have power on his. I'm so confused. Alright, let's make a push here. Push here to someone. Oh. We need to push up when you start breaking beacons. And we need to play smart. Thank you, jumped off the map. Oh no! I had that too, and I had my Kraken. That would have been game over. It wouldn't even been funny. Yes, we took the lead. Woo, let's go. And we still got time for one more. Yes. Oh, that was an intense game, but we got the win. I'm surprised I didn't end up super jumping onto it, because that was my plan. But oh well. 14-11. We put up some big games with this. I still do like the 96 Cal as my AR now. I was also using a Museum Delfoncino. Great. Keltum. Great. It's so good on so many maps just because it has so much map control with the splash walls. It's got just good damage. If it had better fire rate, it would literally be the best weapon in the game, no doubt in my mind. But obviously, it has to have something to sort of nerf it. And that's what puts the subs and specials, because the Kraken is just amazing. It can get you out of so many tight jams, which I know is one of the most frustrating things in the game, actually, Panic Krakens. But it's so clutch. And then, again, as I said, throwing down splash wall, just, it can cut off entire portions of the map. hoping I could stay under that. That would have been so clutch. Not ideally where I wanted to blast in, but it got a kill, so we'll live with it. I just didn't have the range to deal with that. Was it 52? Yeah. Oh well. Unlucky, but I should not have put myself in that position though. I should have played the kill. No, no, no. That is one of the things that will continue to anger me, is the fact that I can swim up it, have it start moving, and just the fact that momentum doesn't really work. Which I guess are probably the actual physics. But it's just annoying. It's a huge issue. You gotta get the kills, guys. Come on. So frustrating to get two kills and just... What just killed me? What? Okay. No, see, I mean, I understand the play. But I don't think we're making the right play right now. We're also really in a pretty good position to lose this game. Where'd that guy go? He must have died, but... Like, you can play such a support role with this button. You're pretty much... You're 90% of the time asking to trade with a, to trade with a Luna Blaster, because you get the kill quick enough, like, in terms of its shot speed. Oh my, oh Jesus. Didn't even know the spot existed. Oh, that wasn't Dynamo. I was fine, because I would have taken the hit. If I had to, I would have Kraken. Wouldn't have been an issue. I'm not saying we would have won. Alright, we gotta push this thing. Get on it! Alright, I'm here. What just happened? Oh, they must have hopped on it. I didn't really have anything I can do there. Oh, well. It's frustrating, but nothing we can do. We go 10-9. Honestly, we put up good numbers, but I just didn't feel like I could be as effective as I wanted to be, and we have not moved in 2 episodes. We are still where we started. But either way, guys, thank you so much for watching. Obviously, if you enjoyed, please hit that like button. and I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.